What's going on my YouTube biddies? I'm Jacob with another movie review for you guys. And continuing on in my series of Pink Panther reviews, I am once again joined by Dave from Interpreting the Stars as we review the third film in this Pink Panther franchise, 1968's Inspector Clouseau. Inspector Clouseau was released in 1968. This was a really bizarre film for the franchise because at the height of the series' popularity, with Peter Sellers starring and Blake Edwards directing, neither one of these two were involved in this film. Peter Sellers and Blake Edwards had a fallout on the set of A Shot in the Dark, and Peter Sellers vowed he would never work with Blake Edwards ever again. They ultimately patched things up and were working on another movie. I think it's called The Party, if I'm not mistaken, a movie I've not seen. The studio was like, hey, we want to make another Pink Panther film. And they're like, hold on, we're working on this movie here. But they wanted to make another Pink Panther movie, I guess, for the 1968 season. And they ended up hiring a different director. This time we got Bud Yorkin. And a different actor, where you got Alan Arkin, of all people, to play Jacques Clouseau. This is a movie that was critically panned even when it first came out in 1968. People hated this film. The film bombed horribly at the box office because people knew there was something off about this film. They thought the direction was terrible. They thought Alan Arkin was awful. And it just didn't feel like a Pink Panther film for a lot of people. So this is seen as a very bizarre film in the Pink Panther franchise. In fact, there's a lot of people who don't even consider this film canon because of the odd placement it is compared to the other films. So what do me and Dave think of this film? Let's find out together. Inspector Jacques Clouseau is on special assignment for Scotland Yard in hopes that a fresh outlook will help the government recover the loot from the Great Train Robbery, which is being used to underwrite a new crime wave. What they don't count on, however, is having more than one Clouseau on the job. This movie is terrible. There, I said it. Inspector Clouseau took a complete nosedive, especially after how amazing and how awesome A Shot in the Dark was. This took a complete nosedive. And it's one of the most painfully unfunny comedies that I have ever seen. The direction in this movie does not work at all. The story is so needlessly complicated. I was struggling to follow along with the story of this film. Some crime waves going on. And then some of the plot devices that are in here. Like you got characters using spy gadgets like it's a James Bond movie. Characters putting on these ridiculous looking Scooby-Doo face masks to disguise as Jacques Clouseau. What is this, a James Bond Mission Impossible parody? What is this? This whole movie just does not feel right. Like, the whole film is one unfunny comedy sketch. Dad, I couldn't tell if the movie was trying to be serious or the film was trying to be funny but failed miserably at it. Not even the direction in this movie could save the film. I'm not familiar with Bud Yorkin as a director, but he paled compared to what Blake Edwards did in the first two films. He just could not recapture that same comical energy. And even the filmmaking in general just looked cheap and amateurish compared to what Blake Edwards mastered so well in the first two films, particularly A Shot in the Dark. Let's talk about Alan Arkin because...
Oh, man.
Talk about a miscast. I tend to enjoy Alan Arkin in some of the movies I've seen over the years. Alan Arkin tends to be a good addition to a lot of movies that I've seen. Edward Scissorhands is a good example of that. And if you have not seen the suspense thriller Wait Until Dark from 1967, where Alan Arkin plays a villain in that movie, that movie is fantastic, and it's great seeing a more sadistic side that you don't expect from an actor that tends to fall into the comedy genre. But I don't think Alan Arkin fits this movie. His fake accent was not impressive. The whole time, since I'm so used to hearing Alan Arkin's distinct New York accent, it conflicts with his fake French accent so much that it felt like I was watching a bad parody of the Pink Panther than a legit Pink Panther movie. That's how turned off I was by Alan Arkin's performance.
No, I'm just your average typical French tourist on a humble English vacation. There is a time for laughing and a time for not laughing. And this is not one of them.
Everything's going to turn out all right.
It's not! They're going to kill me! They're going to kill me, I tell you!
The slapstick does not work. It's painfully unfunny. The timing is off half the time, and you can just tell how desperate the filmmakers were and that they were trying to recapture what Blake Edwards did so successfully, and they just couldn't translate it because, at least at this time, your two geniuses in the franchise were Blake Edwards and Peter Sellers, and neither of them were involved in this film. And it just shows. And I think this movie is absolutely terrible. Before I dive into two very slight redeemable positives about this garbage movie, let's hear what Dave from Interpreting the Stars has to say on Inspector Clouseau.
What's up? I'm back on Jacob's channel, bringing it back to the Pink Panther series of films, with the third film in the series, which I'm just gonna try to pretend doesn't exist. It's Inspector Clouseau. When an elusive group of thieves commits a string of robberies across Europe, the British Prime Minister enlists the expertise of bubbling sleuth Inspector Clouseau, this time played by Alan Arkin. To complicate matters, the crimes are suspected to be connected to a Scotland Yard dirty cop, so Clouseau must save the day all on his own. However, he finds himself in a tricky situation when he is kidnapped and the robbers use a mask of his own face to conceal their identity while they continue to rob banks. First of all, it's great to be back on Jacob's channel talking about yet another Pink Panther film, even if they aren't always as great as I remember them being as a kid. First, I mean, the original Pink Panther film wasn't as great as it could have been, and then there's this, Inspector Clouseau, which has Alan Arkin in the lead role of Clouseau instead of Peter Sellers, which was potentially the strangest and gravest mistake that it made, which was just the peak of a very large iceberg, and Peter Sellers isn't the only missing person from the original two movies, because so is the director, Blake Edwards. And these two, Sellers and Edwards, they're essentially the soul of the entire franchise, so if they're both gone, what you end up with is a joke, or at least something that doesn't scream official film. I believe the two of them were busy making another movie when the producers were like, you know, I want to make another Pink Panther movie. And they're all like, you know, hold your horses. And they're all like, you know what, screw you, we're going to make it anyway. So they call up Alan Arkin. They say, hey, you want to take the reins? And he's like, yeah. So he did. Look, you know, I have nothing against Alan Arkin. I think he's an incredible actor who has impressed me time and time again in a variety of different genres. But he's no Clouseau. Clouseau is just one of these characters that is so memorable and so iconic that only one person can ever naturally play them, and that one person's Peter Sellers. It's kind of like Harrison Ford as Han Solo or Indiana Jones. You know, anybody else taking the role, it just would feel wrong, and it feels wrong with Alan Arkin. What's worse is that Arkin doesn't seem to understand comedic timing. We all know that Clouseau's supposed to be this bumbling guy with a number of nervous tics and antics, and the same definitely goes here, but this type of physical humor needs proper timing to work. The first time that you see Clouseau in this film, he's stepping off of an airplane, and it's raining, he gets to the bottom of the steps before he realizes, oh look, you know, he's not wearing shoes, so his socks and his feet are getting wet. And so, you know, he has to go back up the stairs to retrieve the shoes, you know, he's knocking people over on the steps. I get it. On paper, I get it. Peter Sellers could probably pull that off. But when Alan Arkin did it, it was just dealt with so matter-of-factly. Like, you know, hey, look, this is supposed to be funny. Because, look, his feet are wet. Ha ha ha. And I just didn't buy it. And this kind of humor occurs from beginning to end, and I never bought it. Because of that, I was just so bored with this movie. I was falling asleep. What about the mystery? Well, It's not exactly a normal Clouseau mystery. It feels a little bit too much like a James Bond or spy espionage film because there's all these spy gadgets, there's like spy car sorts, there's masks that people wear of other people's faces like Clouseau. That's kind of like Mission Impossible. And while this is somewhat original for a Pink Panther film specifically, it felt too weird. Like, you know, why? Clouseau's not a spy, he's not in the special forces or whatever, he's a detective with the police. Past that, there is once again another musical score, not the Pink Panther theme song, and this time, it's the worst score of the first three movies, it's annoying, even the cartoon animated intro felt lazy and uncreative. All in all, I gotta say, there wasn't much going on here that I liked. I even thought that the majority felt kind of convoluted and confusing, and I kind of just wanted to pretend that it never existed in the first place. I want to skip it and just stick with Peter Sellers' movies, but I guess it is what it is. Let's take a look at my final score for a second. Where does this technically go right? In not many places. I mean, the best that I can say is that it mostly did what it wanted to do, even though what it wanted to do wasn't what other people wanted it to do. So, I don't know. Other than that, it was business as usual. Until you start looking at things like casting choices, which were garbage, badly timed jokes, and a mediocre mystery. The unbiased technical score is 40%. My bias score is quite a bit lower because I didn't like the movie. I was bored. I was falling asleep. I hated the casting change. I didn't like the mystery. I wanted it to end something like 10 minutes into the movie. This score is 28%, and when we average out the two scores together, we come to the final rating of 34%. 34 out of 100 possible stars, or a flaming bag of crap letter grade of F. Ah, ouch. How do you even go from such an awesome movie like Shot in the Dark to this? Maybe it's like the Star Trek series, where it has a Star Trek curse, where the odd-numbered films are worse than the even-numbered films. I guess time will only tell. But thank you once again for Jacob to inviting me to your channel. It was something. Honestly, I didn't even remember this movie whatsoever. I know I saw it once, but I don't remember it. I'm curious to hear what you have to say about this one, so I'm not gonna hog your channel any longer. Let's hear what the rest of what you have to say about Pink Panther 3, Inspector Clouseau. Peace out.
Thank you, Dave, for sharing your thoughts on Inspector Clouseau. And yeah, we're pretty much on the same page with this movie. We tend to be in agreement on these Pink Panther films so far. We're 3 for 3. This is such a terrible movie. I was struggling to get into this film, too. It's boring, it's painfully unfunny, and Alan Arkin was such a miscast in the title role. I'm sorry I had to put you through this one, but hopefully we'll get back on track to great films in the Pink Panther franchise as the next film does bring back Blake Edwards as director and Peter Sellers in the starring role. So I'm hoping things are back on track again there. I'll leave a link in the description below where you can check out Dave's YouTube channel, Interpreting the Stars. Dave also does movie reviews on his channel, and he has some interesting tidbits and perspectives that he brings in the world of film criticism. I enjoy the unique grading scales that he has on his channel, and he has some interesting analysis on the movies that he talks about on his channels. Also, the editing in his videos are top-notch, and he typically has amazing intros building into the reviews. So give Dave some love, give him a like, give him a subscribe, tell him I sent you, and without further ado, back with my review on Inspector Clouseau. So there was only about two positives I could think of when watching Inspector Clouseau, because this movie's not all awful, even though this is a bad movie. Even though the title sequence in this film isn't as fresh or isn't as creative as in the previous two films, I did find some mild enjoyment out of the title sequence because I think it was animated by the same people who did the previous two, so having that tradition even in a bad Pink Panther movie is better than having no animated title sequence in a Pink Panther movie. Also, there's a car chase about 3/4 into the film that I thought was decently directed and it grabbed my attention at least. But other than that, this movie is utterly awful. Like, there was not once in this movie where I laughed throughout, because the comedy, the timing, the slapstick, none of it worked for me. I could not buy Alan Arkin as Jacques Clouseau, And the weird plot elements in this movie, whether it's ridiculous gadgetry, the Scooby-Doo mask, the plot meandering throughout like it's an unfunny SNL sketch. This movie has no flow to it whatsoever. I was bored throughout a good chunk of the film. And this is one of the most dreadful comedies that I've ever had to sit through. I don't think this film is offensively bad like some of Adam Sandler's bad comedies like Jack and Jill. This film is just boring, unfunny, and unfocused. And I did not have a good time watching this film. I was struggling with a bad headache while watching this film. And watching this stinker of a film, I think, made the experience a little worse. So, shame on you, Inspector Clouseau. This is a terrible movie. Easily the worst of the three films we've covered in this series so far. And I'm going to give Inspector Clouseau a 1 out of 5 stars. And on the 100-point scale, it's getting a 12 out of 100. So that wraps up my review of Inspector Clouseau as part of my series of Pink Panther reviews. I plan on having Dave from Interpreting the Stars join me on all the other Pink Panther reviews, continuing on with the Peter Sellers films along with the rebooted films with Steve Martin. Even though I did not enjoy this film, I'm excited to dive into the other Pink Panther films. The next film in our series will be the 1975 film The Return of the Pink Panther, bringing back Peter Sellers as Jacques Clouseau and Blake Edwards as a director. So hopefully that'll bring the series back to greatness once again, and I'm excited to check that one out for the first time. If you missed our other reviews, I'll leave a link in the description below or on the iCard up above where you can check out our playlist, where you can check out the reviews for the first Pink Panther and The Shot in the Dark if you'd like to catch up on those reviews. And again, I'll leave a link in the description below where you can check out Dave's YouTube channel, Interpreting the Stars. And if you haven't already, give him a like and give him a subscribe as well. And check out the amazing content that's over on his YouTube channel. If you've seen Inspector Clouseau, let me know down in the comments below what you thought of the film. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Were you mixed on it? But whatever your thoughts are, please be civil and respectful of others. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. Click the subscribe button to see more content and the notification bell next to it so you can be notified of future videos. If this is your first video, I usually do movie reviews, TV reviews, ranking videos, and other fun stuff along the way. I have some more videos planned for you soon. Hope you all have an amazing day. God bless, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!